Hello everyone, welcome to SEMSTAR online classes. I'm Rubab Rizvi and I'm here to take your computer class, chapter 3, How Does a Computer Work? Revision part 2.
So students, in the previous class, I told you about the computer, that how does computer work. And I told you that computer works through IPO cycle, that is input, process and output. Yes, remember? Right? Computer works through input, process and output. It works in 3 basic steps, input, process and output. I give you the examples also. I give you an example of a broken pencil, sharpener and then dirty clothes. Then about our body part, that teacher was asking the question, yes. Then about our body part. Then I also gave you one example of making a mango shake, if you remember, right? So in this way, I gave you the real life examples of input, process and output. And today we are going to learn how computer works through IPO, that is input, process and output. Okay, so let's start children. Let's read the chapter. First one is input. The data and instructions that we enter into a computer are called input. Children, now all the pictures, information, numbers, symbols that we enter into the computer, we put into the computer, that is called input, right? So all the information, data that we enter into the computer, that is called input. Okay, so now we next come to process. Now when we enter all the instructions, pictures, letters, numbers, everything into the computer, the work of process start. And what is the work of, and which part of computer do all the process? Yes, CPU, isn't it? Yes. Working on the data is called processing. And now all that data that you enter into the computer, CPU works on that and that is called processing. Okay, that is called processing and that is process. The CPU is doing its process. The CPU works on the data and does all the thinking and calculation. The last one is output. Now children, we have entered the all the data into the computer, that and that is called input. Now the work of process start, processor do all its work, that is CPU start doing its work and gives out the final result. And that is called what? Output. Okay? That is called output. Output means the final result. Output is also called final result. Okay, children? The output means the final result. When the CPU finishes processing the data, the output is displayed on the... Where is the output displayed, children? Yes, it is displayed on the monitor, isn't it? It is displayed on the monitor. Whatever the result is, it is displayed on the monitor. Yes. When CPU finishes processing the data, the output is displayed on the monitor. Monitor and printer are the most common output devices. Now, this keyboard, children, now keyboard through which we enter the data, that is called input device. Your keyboard is the input device, right? Keyboard, yeah, your keyboard, this is an input device. And the result that is displayed on the monitor, the monitor is called an output device. And processor CPU does all the processing work. Okay, so this remember children, I can ask in the question, I can ask in exam that keyboard and mouse are input device, true or false? Maybe I can ask like this. So is it true or false? Yes, keyboard and mouse are input devices. We enter the information into the computer through either keyboard or mouse. Mouse is also your input device. Okay, and output device, monitor, printer. Printer is also your output device. Okay, so monitor and printer are the most common output devices. Okay, understood? Keyboard and mouse are your input devices because we enter the data into computer through keyboard and mouse, right? Then the work of processor starts, that is CPU, start its work and start thinking and giving the result, all thinking and calculation it do, and then give the final result, and the final result is the output, right? And what are the output devices? That is monitor and printer. Yes, printer and monitor are the most common output devices. Okay children, let's take one last example that how computer work. Let us understand the working of computer with an example. The data and instructions together are called input. Now you know that the data and instructions are called, what are they? They are called input. Yes. For example, if you want to do simple calculation on a computer. So here 2 and 5 are the data and plus is the instruction. Now simple calculation you want to do on a computer. For example, you want to add 2 plus 5. So children, 2 and 5, these are your inputs, right? And plus, this plus is the instruction that you are giving to the computer that I want to add these two numbers. If you put a multiplication sign, then it is going to give you the different result. So it depends what instruction you are giving to the computer. So here we are asking the computer and giving the instruction to the computer to add these two numbers. So instructions are also given to the computer, right? Now when you enter these two numbers and put a sign of plus, now the work of CPU starts. Now the CPU will work on the data according to the instruction, that is, it will add the two numbers. Okay, it will add the two numbers. When it will start adding the two numbers, then it is called process. First they were your inputs, right? CPU starts calculating, then it is called process, and the result that you get, that is 7, is the final result, and that is the output. So through like this children, step by step computer works. It works through input process and output cycle. I hope this example is clear to you. I hope this chapter is clear to you. All the examples that I have given is clear to you about this pencil, then dirty clothes, about the body, about the mango shape I have given you. It's a very nice example to make you understand what is input, process and output. So I hope children, it is clear to you all. So with this we come to the end of the chapter and with the end of computer syllabus also of FA1, that is assessment 1. Okay children, so please now your work is to learn everything, revise everything, learn the spellings, learn every fill in the blanks, true and false, and all the best for your assessment 1 exam. Take care and bye bye.